Welcome to the Hastings Arts Center for another coffee concert. So excited to present this concert. I'm wearing several hats today among performing. So just a few housekeeping things before we begin. If you didn't grab a program, they are at the door. On the back is the list of some upcoming events. The next coffee concert is March 24th with Hannah Flowers, who is a harpist, a Celtic harpist. We also have a really cool event happening on Friday, March 27th. The OK Factor is two women that are violinist and cellist, and they actually will be doing a residency in the schools with the Hastings High School and Middle School Orchestra students. And then they'll be bringing the students here for a concert that evening, Friday, March 27th, 7 p.m. Tickets will be online soon, I promise. Now, please silence anything that might make noise during the performance, cell phones, pagers. Do people even have pagers anymore? anything that might make a noise. We are having this concert professionally recorded. Along with that, I ask that you do not video during the performance. It can be distracting to the people around you, and we are having it recorded. We are also having a live feed on my iPad back there. So, and the concert will actually be on Facebook later for your own viewing pleasure later, and you can share it with people. So I will be right back with Karen Beacom. But as soon as, let me just preface it and just say that Karen and I are old college buds. And when Karen and I met, she was a harp major and I was a violin major. And so it just goes to show you that you never know where your lives will lead. And so we are still musicians, but I ended up doing more piano than violin, although I still teach violin. Karen still plays the harp, but she has become a fabulous opera singer. And I first heard her sing when we were in college, and it was her senior year, and I did a fifth year. And I saw her in Magic Flute. She was one of the ladies. And I went up to her afterwards. I said, "Where did this voice come from?" And she said, "I don't know," in such a singing way. It was great. So she went on and found some fabulous teachers and has just grown into this beautiful singer, beautiful person. So I'm really excited that she's here for us to share music with you. So we'll be right back.
Thank you.
Center. It's great to be in Minnesota. It's a lot warmer this year. It was 30 below the entire week I was here last year. So we're really enjoying the Minnesota hospitality and a little spring. I come from Michigan these days, so it is warmer here. That was Uno Voce Poco Fa from Rossini's Barber of Seville, and you got to experience a little bit of the feistiness and playfulness of Rosina as she falls in love with Lindoro and says that he does love her, but if he doesn't, watch out. We're going to bring it back to a little bit of German Lieder right now. We're going to just do a little potpourri, some Schubert, Schumann, and then a couple of Strauss, and we've added one Strauss today that we thought would fit today's program. So we will start with Schubert's Heilige Nacht, called Nacht und Träume.
Thank you.
was Schumann's Widmung, which means dedication. So the piece that we'd like to insert today is from Strauss, a book of 30 songs. There's more, but this is one collection. And we're gonna do Aller Seelen. And I thought I'd just read the poetry to you of this one before we sing it. And we'll do the same with the next one. Place on the table the fragrant mignonettes. Bring here the last of red asters, and let us speak again of love. As long ago in May, give me the hand that I may secretly clasp it, and if it is observed by others, I will not mind. Give me one of your sweet glances, as long ago in May. Today each grave is flowering and fragrant. Once a year is All Souls' Day. Come to my heart, that I again may have you, as long ago in May. Devotion by Strauss. As you know it, dear soul, that far from you I languish. Love causes hearts to ache. To you my thanks. Once drinking to freedom, I raise the amethyst cup, and you bless the drink. To you my thanks. You exorcise the evil spirits in it, so that I, as never before, cleansed and freed, sank upon your breast. To you my thanks. something on the piano there with Miss Sarah Lockwood and that beautiful sign line.
And
Back around to the beginning of the stages of falling in love and pick our spirits up a bit after the tragic ending that we all know of West Side Story. Mimi in Puccini's La Boheme meets a poet named Rodolfo. They are bohemians living in the artist's world in Paris, and the lights go out, and Mimi uses this and Rodolfo as well as an opportunity to get her candle ignited, and they meet and they introduce themselves to each other, and this is C, mi chiamano Mimi, and this is her introduction to Rodolfo.
Thank you. opera, Rodolfo responds and then tells her all about himself, and then they sing the famous love duet, O Suave Fantula, and go party into the night at the festivities, the holiday festivities. We're gonna go to our Copland set right now, so you'll understand the words this time. Zion's Walls is our first selection, followed by At the River, and a little Chingering Chaw.
Join us.
about the promised land and the promised glory. You don't need to fear if you have no money. You don't need a man to buy you milk and honey. There you ride in style, coached with four-white horses. Now the evening meal has 1, 2, 3, 4 courses. Traviata, Violetta, and I'm just preparing this role, so this will be this aria's first time out in public. So we thought if you would indulge us, and we'd love to sing a little of Strano, Violetta's aria, where she explores her feelings of, does she really deserve this thing called love with her suitor?
Thank you.
to be so much fun. If you like to travel, that will be done in Sault Ste. Marie with the Sioux Opera Company in August, the 5th, 7th, and on Mackinac Island on the 9th. So please, anybody in the live Facebook world, check us out. Well, we've got a lovely production scheduled for August of La Traviata. We'd just like to send you off on a piece that's by a composer who is the chorus master and a musician in Nashville. She's the chorus master of the Nashville Opera. And she and I were in a mutual wedding together of one of my very best friend Dawn's. And this piece was sung at her wedding, and ever since then I've wanted to learn it. It's a beautiful piece based on the 23rd Psalm. So we'd like to leave you with that today.